have to admit, I'm not actually that comfortable with where we're going.
I'm actually really looking forward to it. There's so much history in this place, so many stories.
I mean, don't forget, it's one of New Zealand's most haunted places. This is like the holy grail for ghost hunting. Auckland's Waikumete Cemetery.
It's such a big area.
Was it 306
acres? Yeah.
Absolutely huge. It's like a suburb in itself.
Yeah.
Well, the suburb of Glen Eden is actually based around the cemetery. Like, the cemetery was here first.
This place actually opened, I think it was, what, 1886? So you've got thousands and thousands and thousands of stories of souls that have been buried here over the years.
Well, 5,000 people died. Well, more than 5,000, actually, from that Spanish influenza. A lot of them will be here. Just so many stories of graveyards with, I guess, spirits with unfinished business, or some who don't even realise that they're dead and keep walking around and that sort of thing. So, yeah, I'm feeling a little bit uneasy about it.
It's kind of an interesting mixture of a place that's really eerie, but also very peaceful, which is quite strange. I guess people, a lot of people, if they had pain in life, now they can rest in peace, some of them.
Okay, Miss Caro, I'm sending you to the café.
Oh, I love you. A café, I'm gonna have some coffee. I'll have a coffee for all of us.
Not so fast, there'll be no coffee for you, thank you very much. The café is actually built on the old railway station, which, hey, guess what, it's haunted.
Well, it would be, wouldn't it?
Exactly. It's haunted by a guy called Alec MacFarlane. And the deal with this guy is he used to take the mail off the trains when it came in. The guard on the train would hang it up on a metal hook and he'd be there to take it off as the train went past. And, of course, one day he wasn't looking and, bang, copped it right between the eyes. Now, apparently, he is still seen on the platform. And he's quite often seen looking at the timetables, waiting for the trains to come in. So hopefully you'll see him tonight. But before you meet up with him, you're going to meet up with Kerry, who works in the cafe, and she's going to tell you about all these sorts of things that the staff have seen up there, which are very cool indeed.
Unbelievable.
Up that way. Thank you, ma'am. Have a good night. I'll see you later on.
Hopefully.
Bye.
And now for you, sir.
Yes.
You're going to be spending the evening right here, in the old part of the cemetery with all the murderers, the paupers, the whole lot. For me, from a technical point, it's going to be a logistical nightmare. But just seeing it so overrun in this section is quite amazing. You see it kind of for what it represents, to be perfectly honest. You know, it's all about death, and that's what it looks like.
About 2 years ago, we moved from the old building to this building, so it's only like 200 metres, and it was my first day working here, and I bent down, got up, and there was a guy standing there, and I was like, oh, we're not actually open yet, so, you know, if you'd like to come back in half an hour. And he was dressed really proper, you know, like proper top hats and things like that, you know, like, yeah, he was old-fashionedly dressed. And then he said, oh, I was actually just wondering if you knew what time the next train came. And I was like, there is a timetable out there if you want to, you know, I wasn't feeling too comfortable with him here.
Yeah.
And then he's turned around and looked at that timetable. So I thought, oh, you know, I'll leave him to it. Carried on to what I was doing. Went into the kitchen, came back out, and he was gone. And I was like, you know, where'd it go?
You heard no click.
Had no click on the doors. So if you try the doors, they make a clicking noise, and you can hear people walking on the platform.
So he
just came and went.
So Arthur, you used to work at the crematorium in the 80s and 90s. Now, do you have any experiences or sightings or things that you saw when you were working here that you could tell us about?
It was a clear day. I just turned to open the door of my car, which was facing the road ahead. And lo and behold, standing in the middle of the road was a lady in bare feet with a long type of gown on. Sort of off-white colour. Her hair was unkempt. But what disturbed me, her gaze was firmly fixed at me. She wouldn't stop looking at me. I thought, just get in your car, don't look at her, back the car out, drive it out the gate, and get out of your car and shut the gate. As I got out of my car to shut the gate, I had a look out of the corner of my eye to see if she was still there, but she had gone. I had never seen that lady before, and I never saw her since. It's just something I've lived with all my life. I've never forgotten it, and never will.
She come down to the, I suppose you'd call it the bowels of the cemetery, one of the oldest parts. I figured this is the best place to put the EMF readings and the temperature gauges. So I think this will be the spot where I'm going to get most EMF fluctuations and temperature drops and all that sort of thing. So just trying to find a good spot to do it. I'm hearing things already. Just trying to find a good spot to do it. Might come up here. Actually, I might just take a couple of photos while I'm... I have no idea what that was, but...
All right, guys, one helmet for each of you.
Thank you.
Perfect. I'll be on with that one. Sweet. So how did your research go?
Oh, Arthur was amazing.
Yeah?
He was so impassioned about what he was actually speaking about. He was starting to almost get tears in his eyes when he was talking about it.
Really?
It was pretty engaging to watch. Yeah, he truly believed in what he had seen and experienced.
You're all set?
I am.
You got all your equipment?
Yep.
Earpieces are set, so I can talk to you?
Yep.
All right. I'll talk to you when you're out there.
Okay.
Cool. Have fun. Cool.
See you later. Such a vast area. There's 306 acres here. The Spanish flu, as it was called, was an epidemic in 1918. Over 5,000 people died from this horrific plague, and over 1,000 of them came to Waikumete Cemetery. And what they basically had to do was open up a huge big trench, which I'm standing on right here. I'm walking over it right now. More than 1,000 people, most of them not in coffins, and just thrown in here, all one on top of another. I don't exactly know if this is the ending that they would have hoped for. There must be quite a few people, I guess, who are not resting in peace.
Yeah, Callum, are you at the train station yet?
Yes, I'm walking along the platform, Brad. This is platform 7. This platform here is where the bodies that were stacked on trains, this was the last stop before they got sent up to the Waikumete Cemetery. One of the most busy times that this platform has had. was when the Spanish influenza hit New Zealand. There were so many bodies that needed to get taken to the cemetery, and the cemetery just could not accommodate for those bodies. So the bodies actually got piled up here on this platform. Also on this platform, the porter, Alec MacFarlane. He survived World War I, he survived the Spanish influenza, but he didn't survive the accident when one day he was standing here and the train took him unawares and the hook that he was meant to get the mail off struck him.
Apparently, they say that the full moon is the best time for spirits to come out, something about the lunar energy. Well, there's the full moon, and here I am, in a graveyard that's been open since 1886. Let's go further down. I mean, either side of me, there's tombstones everywhere. And each and every one of them, I guess, has their own story. In life and in death. I'm gonna head down to what's called Murderer's Grove. And as its name suggests, this is where 19 of New Zealand's murderers were hung and buried in this area. They weren't allowed any kind of markings whatsoever. So what they did instead, just to mark the area so people would know where it was, is they planted what were known as ghost gums underneath my feet, I guess right now, were some of New Zealand's most condemned criminals.
What is that beeping noise?
I'm not sure, Carol. I'm picking it up as well. Is it coming from the street?
No, it's inside. It's the alarm!
That's really odd. The alarm was disengaged while I was setting up, so there's absolutely no reason that it should be going off. It's turned off.
Oh, no.
Right, now this is starting to get a bit creepy. I've kind of gone off the main cemetery, and I'm heading into the further into the bush itself. Brad, I don't know if you can pick up anything, but it's a pretty chilling kind of environment down here. I'm off the cemetery path, and I'm in the bush. Can you hear me, Brad? No, what's that?
You there, Brad?
Yep, I can see you coming through the door, Carolyn.
This is the old train station. In the kitchen, there's been many sightings of ghosts at the window. Cupboards and drawers opening. Plates falling out of cupboards when there's been no one in the kitchen.
Hey there, Carolyn.
Yep, I'm here.
Yeah, I'm not getting any aberrations at all from any of my readings in this room, so I might get you to head back to the cemetery and back down to Alex MacFarlane's grave, and let's see if he's not down there.
What? The cemetery? Did you say the cemetery? This honestly feels like I'm stuck somewhere in the middle of the Blair Witch Project. I'm scared out of my brain as well. What on earth? Oh my God. Here's a really old one here. I can't even read the name. It's got a ripped up tiger. That's pretty sinister. Oh my God. Oh. Oh, you gave me such a fright.
Are you okay?
No.
What did give you a fright?
Look at that over there.
What is it? Bizarre.
Hello, Carolyn. Have you located the grave of Alexander MacFarlane yet?
No, I'm just looking for that now. I've got Michael with me. Thank goodness.
Oh, cool, because I lost radio contact with him a little while ago. I need you both to locate his grave and take as many photographs as you can.
I'm sure.
Yeah, I'm looking at the map. It should be about halfway up the hill that you're currently standing on. I've set up
quite a few thermometers around the cemetery, and I'm getting an inexplicable temperature drop around about his gravestone.
I think this might be it.
Alexander.
That's him.
There he is. Yeah, I might just take a photo. Perfect. Should we head back up to the van and see if Brad's got anything worth looking at?
Yeah.
Well, what an interesting night. A full moon in a cemetery. It all bodes well, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Michael, tell me about when you were down in the Spanish influenza area in the murderer's row.
You're standing on top of, was it 1,600 bodies, victims, whatever, and it's you know, just quite horrid to be standing there. But
yeah, and you took this photo when you were down there, which just came up with so many orbs. Isn't all the fun?
Wow.
It's quite remarkable.
It's like clusters of them. It's such a high intensity of orbs together. What does that kind of suggest?
That you're standing on 1,600 dead people and they've come up to visit.
It's just amazing to get that many in an area where there were so many people that were buried.
Yeah.
It's quite remarkable. The other photo that you took is another orb photograph.
Huh.
But it's this one on the left-hand side.
A blue orb.
A blue orb. And we're just lifting the light, the contrast. The orb actually goes a bright blue. I can't explain that at all. Now, I have to blow my own horn for a little bit because for once I managed to get a good photo.
So I think this will be the spot where I'm going to get most EMF fluctuations and temperature drops and all that sort of thing. So I'm just trying to find a good spot to do it. I'm hearing things already. Just trying to find a good spot to do it. Might come up here.
Well, I just took some photographs on the spur of the moment. And that was a photograph that I took. These two here are tombstones, and then this odd figure in the middle, which kind of looks like a guy wearing a hat, if I could be so bold.
Right. So, Stephanie, it's not a tombstone.
Well, that's what I was thinking. As it turns out, earlier on, when I go down and I take photographs and do a recce, if you like, of trying to figure out where I'm going to put all the different equipment, that was the photo that I took because I knew that's where I was going to place the tri-field meter. And there's just nothing in there that would indicate that it would be another tombstone.
Okay.
So I can't figure out what this figure is that seems to be rising up from the ground.
Do you think it could be, if I can pose the question, that might be, say, the ghost of Alexander MacFarlane?
It could well be. It was down in the area of his grave. And why he'd be down there, I would have thought he'd be up on the platform.
Well, that's where his tragedy occurred.
And we'll go through a couple of things that did happen on the platform while you were up there. When you walked in, the alarm went off.
Yeah, that was weird.
It was weird. And I'm going to show you this. Now, the alarm is right next to the door there. If you were to put the alarm on, it would automatically set itself. Now, there's no one there. And then suddenly, that is the alarm setting itself. There was no one around, and we actually got it on tape, the alarm just turning itself on. Now, when you're inside, you walk out of the kitchen and you can see your shadow disappears.
Yes.
And watch the window in the background on the right-hand side.
It might have just been a person.
But this is the wide shot, and there's no person that walks past because there's a camera that's right there. And then I also have this camera, yeah, which is pointing straight at that window. And you'll see your torch shine inside, yeah, so that's you inside. And then you go out of the room, and there's nothing. I would have assumed if a person walked past, they would have to walk in between the camera and the window.
It looks very transparent, though.
It does look very transparent.
Solid form.
How strange. I didn't like the kitchen, though. I really didn't like the kitchen. I remember saying just shining my torch even through the windows was quite disconcerting because I half expected to see a face through the window.
Well, that's what we got.
Well, I'm glad I didn't see it at the time. I was sort of
left.
Ran it like a screaming girl.
I would have thought that Waikumete Cemetery would be a very calm place because it's where people are at rest, but I think we've proved otherwise and maybe even found the spirit of Mr. Alexander MacFarlane.
I cannot believe the figure going past the window, and I just thank God that I didn't see it when I was in there. It would have been so scary. But the kitchen is where a lot of things happen in that place, so I'm not surprised it was that window.
When I saw the footage, I was really taken aback. I was quite surprised that there was so much evidence there.
When it happens to you, it's a strange feeling to hear noises and to feel yourself a bit freaked out. Maybe I shouldn't get too upset when the others feel like that when they're inside, and I shouldn't give them too much grief now that it's happened to me.